Hello, there's an Ebola virus outbreak in West Africa affecting mainly four countries: Liberia, Sierra Leone, Guinea, and Nigeria. It all started in March of 2014, and this is the largest outbreak since the Ebola was first discovered in 1976. This is James, and this is an Ebola virus belonging to the virus family Filovirus. The Ebola virus infects a monkey and a bat, and these animals come in contact with James when he is in Liberia for a business trip. He gets infected with the Ebola virus, but he does not notice that he has been infected, since the incubation period, the time between exposure and symptoms, are about 5 to 10 days. And this is really scary, because now James flies home to his wife and infects her too, through skin contact, kissing, sex, touching the same things in their home, and even by breathing the same air. She in turn visits her friends, who gets infected too, and so on. An Ebola outbreak happens in this country too. After about 5 days, James' skin starts to appear red due to bleeding under his skin, also called hemorrhage, or more specifically small petechiae or larger ecchymosis and maculopapular rash. He develops pharyngitis, fever, problems with breathing, coughing, chest pain, muscle pain called myalgia. James also develops liver problems like jaundice, and his lymph node gets infected and enlarged, and this is called lymphadenopathy. Then he develops abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. His eyes turns red because of conjunctival infection, and he is more sensitive to light called photophobia. James develops headache, delirium, which is a disturbed state of mind. Then he develops stupor, which is a state of near unconsciousness. And lastly, he enters coma, which is a state of deep unconsciousness. 25 to 90% of people who get infected die, and the average is about 50%. James died, unfortunately, because of multiple organ failure. His wife got sick too, but luckily she recovered after about 2 weeks. Half of her friends died, and half survived. The half that survived got complications, which prolonged their recovery to much more in 2 weeks. The complications were recurrent hepatitis, transverse myelitis, uveitis, and orchitis. How can we prevent this disaster from happening? As soon as we suspect anybody having Ebola based on these symptoms or based on having friends that have the disease, we immediately need to call for doctors. Doctors will diagnose each case based on the symptoms, blood tests, and laboratory techniques like enzyme-linked immunosorbent blood assay, also called ELISA, or we can use polymerase chain reaction, also called PCR. But the gold standard of method of detection is the electron microscopy. Now that we know that it really is Ebola virus, what do we do next? You would probably guess that treat the person, but we don't have any treatment available. So what we can do then is that we only give supportive care. And the most important action is prevention. We have to prevent the persons who are already infected to contact more people. So we put them into a quarantine, meaning that we isolate them from other people. We sterilize all the equipment that were in contact with the patient. We educate people of the importance of this outbreak. Last but not least, we don't travel to these areas which are affected.